It is about trust, friendship, and having a partner to share all life has to offer. It is a commitment to participate in the process of mutual evolution, of tears that freely flow.
When you're friends with Kristen, there's a lot to cheer on. She is so strong and so resilient, as so many have said already tonight. You know, she is really vocal about the fact that she has ulcerative colitis, and I have seen her go from being hospitalized once a month and not able to walk up our stairs of our apartment to being in a triathlon and hiking the Grand Canyon, not to mention going to business school and crushing it and marrying the man of her dreams. So needless to say, she is the strongest and most resilient woman that I know.
Although Kristen is a gift from God to you, she is not a gift intended for you alone. You are asked by God to so love this woman that in your love she might find herself as God has created her. So beautiful, so strong, and true. So true that the entire world might be blessed by the presence of a woman who shines so as she relaxes in your arms when you're not crying.
Sitting at a fairly conservative restaurant in New York, and suddenly I'm sitting there by myself. Nobody showed up at Cliff, and he's sitting next to me and sort of sheepishly looked over and goes, "I need to talk to you about something." And before he got about halfway through the sentence, what did he do? Started crying. But after today, I guess we all know this is okay. You're a deep-feeling, deep-hearted man, and that's a great thing. That's a great thing. Don't ever let that go away. Don't let everybody like me make fun of you about it ever again. I'm tired of the supernatural delight. Everybody was dancing in the
turns water into wine. Now, to be honest, I'm an Italian priest. My grandfather used to do that miracle in the garage. The miracle is a little bit more sublime. It is what you two are doing right now. Jesus tells the world that the miracle at Cana comes first because of love, because of commitment, because of two people that are so truly in love that it can change the world.
Say about Kristen, she's perfect, she's smart, she's charming, she's charismatic, she's empathetic. I hope your kids get literally all of your genes.
I'm so happy that you have found someone who can be your support system. I'm so happy that you have somebody who sees all the beautiful things in you that I do that he can respect, the strength in you, the perseverance in you, and that you are also willing to lean on him and not always be the strongest one.
Fucking love cheers. Unless they watch my dad.
The first reason why I love Kristen is that she is one of the most caring individuals I have ever met. Her first instinct is to put others first, friends, family, whoever. She has been this way since the day I met her and has always helped make my life better. She truly is special. The second reason why I love her is tied into the first. She makes me a better person. She is constantly the voice of reason in my life. The person who cares more for me than I do myself. And it's always pushing me to be the best version of myself.
Your dream is the thing that made Kristen get up, stand up, get out of a hospital in San Francisco, go to New York and find a path to where she was today. And I'd like to say you strutted out, but when I saw you get off the airplane, you were sort of walking like a grandma. So, but loyalty to yourself is an important thing, but loyalty to your family is everything. And I think that's the thing that I most treasure, and I hope that you two take away, is that you have what we have, and the Cook family has it, and we certainly have it, where you know that wherever you are, whatever you do, wherever you go, you're a stronger, more confident person because you know that somebody will always be there for you. And that's true.
Reason I love Kristen is her love of family. We bonded over this when we started dating. It was actually a source of some early conflict as we fought over whose family we would spend more time with. She cares about being close with both of our families. And I can tell she will be an amazing mother someday. And the fourth reason I love Kristen is that she is the highlight of my day. Waking up with her and seeing her before I go to bed helps me handle whatever other garbage I had to deal with that day. It was perfect except for that. She is my person.
From a very young age, she was asked to step up and take a role of responsibility and maturity that very few people would have done. And I always tell people, Kristen and my dad raised me. And today I look at her and I think, you're not just my sister. You are, you cried before me. You are my sister. You're kind of like my mother. You are my best friend. You're my role model. And I knew every time I did something wrong, I wasn't just gonna get a phone call from dad. I was gonna get an even worse one from you. And I just, I prayed to God that dad would come first. So that would be like, get it out of the way.
Cliff is passionate about almost everything in life, and I really mean everything. Where I tend to run middle of the road with my approach to the highs and lows of life, Cliff takes them with every ounce of feeling in his bones. His generosity and innate desire to want to love and give to those around him. Cliff is one of the most generous people I know. Cliff does everything with passion and makes life so much more interesting. Life is more fun. Smaller moments hold more meaning. And my dreams are bigger because of Cliff. He inspires me always to think of new ways to have an impact on the world and those around me. He is value driven. I love Cliff for sharing many of the same values. Family, charity, hard work, generosity are just some of them. He embraces my individuality, my independence, and pushes me to think about my own perspective and values in challenging ways, and I am a better person for it.
I wish Mom could be here today. This is one of the days where I miss her the most, and I know you miss her too. Sorry, I'm laughing, I'm not sobbing yet. Something that has given me a lot of comfort today is knowing that Mom is smiling down on Sissy just a little extra hard, and I think she's even more at peace knowing that you have such a beautiful and bright future with Cliff.
I'm cheating a little bit here because this really is a reason why I know I love Cliff. He is the one I want to be with when life and our relationship is tough. Over the past 5 years, we have gone through some very high highs and even some low lows. in a very condensed amount of time. Kristen will talk about her mother. We'll talk about being ill. We'll talk about new treatments, the move back east, multiple job changes, loss of a grandparent, a new career, even that beautiful new puppy that's outside. And all of this, because of you, Cliff, is full of joy. You have made even the stressors able to deal with. I would be devastated without Cliff and would be missing a piece of my heart and the part of my life that has become so much better because he is a part of it. This is the person I need next to me throughout life. I love him for being vulnerable and loving our relationship. I know he's up for the fight when necessary, even if he doesn't know it himself, because he makes it clear in his words and actions. Every day, he loves me and our relationship too much to ever let it fail.
The truth is, you have the thing is, you have the highest like moral standards of any person I've ever met in my entire life. Like, your core set of values is so genuinely perfect. And Kristen, like, you, as lucky as Cliff is, you're like equally as lucky to have such an upstanding person in today's world.
Whether it's been spending holidays together, family trips, and yes, this is a thing we actually did, all night Madden franchise fantasy draft tournaments, which lasted like 2 games because I kept cheating somehow. I told him stop drafting Jets and do much better. From that day on, you were always the best friend a guy could ask for. And you know what they say, beside every great man is an even greater woman.
I, Clifford,
take you, Kristen.
Take you, Kristen.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true.
I promise to be true.
To you in good times.
To you in good times.
And in bad.
And in bad.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Take you, Clifford.
Take you, Clifford.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true.
I promise to be true.
To you in good times.
To you in good times.
And in bad.
And in bad.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Kristen, I am in awe of you. I am so grateful to be your friend and for you to be a friend to me. It has been such a pleasure to watch your love story and to be a part of it and to watch someone love you the way that Cliff loves you.
is my legal right as a minister, but it is my truly greatest joy as a priest to now declare you both husband and wife. Cliff, you may kiss his beautiful bride.